Hi, my name is Darrick, and I'm a Best Buy Home expert. And today, we're answering the question, what is a Wi-Fi router? Let's get into it, starting with how internet gets into your house in the first place. It starts with an internet service provider, also known as an ISP. The ISP offers internet connections, typically through a cable that runs into your house and connects to a modem, like this Netgear Nighthawk cable modem. Now, even though it looks similar to the wireless router, a modem has a very different function. The modem is receiving the internet from the ISP physically through a coax cable. So for most, your household's internet lives in this box, the cable modem. However, to access the internet, most cable modems only offer wired connections, meaning you have to physically connect the cable to one of these Ethernet ports to access it. So if your modem is downstairs and you want to use your laptop upstairs, your only option is to run a cable through the house to make it happen. Not ideal. Not to mention, if you're trying to connect something without an Ethernet port, like a smart doorbell or camera, it simply might not be possible. You need something to take the internet connection and throw it wirelessly through floors and walls, eliminating the need for the cable. Well, that's exactly what the wireless router does. It sends your internet signal wirelessly through the air to reach your devices. So, to recap, you get internet from an ISP, typically through a cable that runs underground and into your house. That cable connects to a modem, and that modem is connected to a Wi-Fi router, which is sending a wireless signal as far as it can throughout your house and possibly beyond. This is the most common setup. However, you should know that there are many different configurations. For example, sometimes the modem already has a built-in wireless router, or now that 5G is becoming more popular, some skip the wired connection from the ISP and the modem altogether. Instead, the wireless router gets the signal from the air just like your cell phone, without the need for a wired connection at all. But for this video, we'll stick with the most common setup, with the line from the ISP into the modem and then into the Wi-Fi router. Okay, so now we know that a Wi-Fi router sends the internet wirelessly throughout your house. Full stop. Let's walk through a few things to consider when picking out the right Wi-Fi router for your needs. First, security. When it's configured properly, it also protects that signal so only your authorized devices can use it. Why? Well, remember, it's a wireless network. A network is a system of connected devices. So while most think of a network as just a one-way street to get internet, it's much more complicated. The devices connected to that network can often speak to each other. So it's actually a two-way street. For example, if you want to transfer files from one computer to another, or maybe you want to send a photo to a printer, or possibly adjust the temperature on your smart thermostat. So if someone has access to your network, they might be able to access the other devices connected to it. And that is why it's important to understand and enable the security features built into your Wi-Fi router. We won't get into the specific settings in this video because they can vary greatly depending on your devices, network, and router. However, just know that security is a key feature of most Wi-Fi routers. So take that into account when selecting one that suits your needs. Most Wi-Fi routers have a dedicated app where you can dial in your settings, set and change your Wi-Fi password, and see if there are any firmware updates for your router to make sure you're using the most secure and stable version of your router as possible. Another key consideration is the range. Wi-Fi routers can throw your internet signal certain distances. That's what these antennas are helping with, extending the range. For example, this Netgear Nighthawk AX6600 is rated for up to 2,500 square feet. Now, you should know that the number isn't exact. It varies greatly depending on the floors, walls, interference, and so on. If your square footage is pushing the Wi-Fi router's limits, you might want to consider something called a mesh network. Mesh networks are a team of Wi-Fi routers, known as nodes, working together to throw the signal even further. It's a blanket of wireless internet coverage that, depending on your devices, can be expanded as your needs increase. For example, if you add outdoor Wi-Fi security cameras, you might need to add another node to your mesh network to expand the coverage so it reaches outside. Mesh networks are also better equipped to handle more devices. Just like the square footage rating, Wi-Fi routers are rated to handle a certain number of devices. For example, this Netgear Nighthawk AX6600 is capable of handling up to 40 devices. So, when you're looking at options, make sure you take that into consideration. Now, you're probably wondering, if a Wi-Fi router sends the internet wirelessly, why are there ports on the back for wired connections? Great question. Wired ports are often faster, which is great for situations where lag matters, like when it comes to gaming and wired connections aren't susceptible to wireless dropouts. All right, Now let's talk about signals. Wi-Fi 6 is one of the fastest options available and a great option for most. However, it's important to know that not all devices are compatible with Wi-Fi 6. Thankfully, most Wi-Fi 6 routers are also backwards compatible with older devices that aren't capable of connecting to a Wi-Fi 6 signal. So there you have it. Those are the basics of a wireless router. Oh, and if you want more info on mesh networks or Wi-Fi 6, we have other videos that you should check out. There are links in the notes below. Hopefully this video was helpful. If you're ready to get started, visit a blue shirt in one of our stores, check out the options on bestbuy.com, or use the link below to set up time with a Best Buy home expert like me. We'll be happy to help. Thanks for watching.